Alright, in this video we are solving a quadratic equation by graphing. So there's multiple different methods of solving quadratics. This one we're going to focus on graphing. So all the quadratics you can graph, just some are a little bit easier than others to solve by graphing. I'll get into why here in a little bit. So if we have y equals x squared plus 2x minus 24 and we want to solve this by graphing, we could use our graphing calculator. In the top left you have y equals, so you can go there and you could type in your equation, x squared plus 2x minus 24. If you need to know how to type in x, it's this button right here. We'll type in x. So we have x squared minus 2x minus 24. So once you're ready to graph it, in the top right is this graph button. So you hit that and you get your graph like this. So in the window, it doesn't really show the full quadratic because it's dipping all the way down here off the screen and coming back up. But the important pieces are what we have on the screen. When you're solving a quadratic equation, all you're looking for is when you have your x and y axis, we're really looking for when y is 0. So we have 0 equals x squared plus 2x minus 24. The only time y is ever 0 is when we're along the x-axis. So what we're really looking for is the points where our graph intersects the x-axis. So in this problem, if you look closely, you'll notice that we can intersect the x-axis over here at positive 4. So one of our answers will be x equals 4. And then the other side, if we look all the way down, that is about negative 6. So we get x equals negative 6 as our other answer. Now, what I mentioned earlier is why we want to use, sometimes we're okay with graphing, sometimes you're not, is sometimes we can get our graph will actually go in between two points. So as of this point, we don't know how to find an exact value for that. So we only like it if it goes through one of our marks on our x-axis. So this is solving by graphing. Again, we're graphing it and you're looking for the x-intercepts and then you just write them as is. So x equals 4, x equals negative 6.